If offered, what do I want to download? A .exe or a .msi? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. If you would have the chance to install a .exe or .msi file, which one would you choose and why? If I remember right, you said that you would choose MSI, but not why. Unfortunately, the file extension alone doesn't really tell me enough to make the decision between an MSI and EXE formatted files. There's a little bit more data needed before we make that decision. It's actually about more than file formats, it's about what those downloads actually do. EXE, for executable, is one of the most basic file formats in Windows. It contains Windows programs, also called apps or applications. Most, though not all, of the programs running on your machine actually start with a .exe file. .msi, for Microsoft Installer, is, as the name implies, an installation file. It contains information used to install a software package into Windows. While not technically a program, it certainly behaves like one because it can be something you run in order to begin the installation process. The program actually processing the instructions is the Windows Installer service, which is actually already part of Windows itself. If you're truly given the option of either a .exe or a .msi in order to install a program, well, they're likely going to do exactly the same thing. In fact, it's quite likely that the .exe actually contains an MSI, which is extracted and then passed on to the Windows Installer service. It's rare, though, that you would be given that choice of an .exe or an MSI to do exactly the same thing. There's no real advantage of one over the other if both are available. Typically, only one will be offered. Unless there's something different. If you're offered only a .exe file to set up a program, it could be an MSI contained within an .exe, as I described. However, it could also be a setup program that doesn't use Windows Installer at all. While application vendors are encouraged to standardize on Windows Installer, they're not required to, and there are many different installation toolkits that can be used instead. The one characteristic that they share is that they almost all begin by running a .exe, often setup.exe. Now, if you're actually presented with both a .msi and a .exe for download, there's likely a very important difference between the two. The MSI installs the software on your machine. That means putting all the right files in all the right places, as well as adding or modifying registry entries and possibly some other things. The .exe, on the other hand, is likely to be a portable version of the application. By that I mean there's no setup involved at all. The .exe is the program. To run the program, you run the .exe, and nothing more. That's the piece of data that's missing. When this is the case, the download page will indicate that this is the portable version. Your choice of MSI versus EXE is really a choice between installing the software regularly or not installing at all, but running it directly. Besides there not being any installation process, the big difference between regular and portable versions include: portable versions are not added to your Windows Start menu. Portable versions don't keep settings in the Windows registry. Some may keep settings and other information in local.ini files, where others simply don't keep any of that information at all, starting with a clean slate every time you run the program. Portable versions typically run really well from USB sticks or networked media. That's where the name portable comes from, as you can take a USB stick from machine to machine to run the software. Some portable versions don't auto-update. Some may tell you there's an update available, but it's usually up to you to download the update and then replace the portable version you have. If you're offered both, and they're truly the same thing, it doesn't matter what you choose, EXE or MSI. MSI might be a tiny bit smaller, I suppose, since it won't have the EXE overhead of needing to extract an MSI to initiate the setup. If you're offered an MSI setup and an EXE portable, as is more likely, then the decision depends on what it is you're attempting to do. I tend to run the installer so as to have everything clearly set up and the program added to my start menu. That being said, I also have utilities that are portable simply because they're small and I do use them on multiple machines, and there's really no advantage to setting them up. The choice, ultimately, is yours. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177972. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.